What is up, YouTube? High Tech Lab here. Today I want to show you guys about this gate that I built for our property. This is on the main road. We have keypad entry, and if we enter the code, you can see opens up. Now one thing you'll notice are there are some pieces of square tube on this here gate. This gate sits on a 6-inch by 6-inch square tube quarter inch wall, and that goes 15 feet in. Well, it's a total of 15 feet. You have about give or take 5 feet in the ground, so we're about 10 feet down. We have about God knows how many pounds of concrete in there. Very strong base. We have some 750 pound gate hinges, top and bottom. Those have a ball bearing and are greased, which it actually sounds like they could use a little more. Coming over to the gate, this is 2-inch by 4-inch by 1/4-inch wall square tubing. And I've welded all this together. In between, we have some 2-inch by 2-inch square tubing. And then again, structural members, 2-inch by 4-inch by 1/4-inch square tubing. On this gate, we have some of these pieces. Now, these used to be a bit more beefy. They used to come out, cut on 45 degree angles and be a spike, because we used to have an issue, not anymore, of people coming and ramming the gates and just damaging the gates, and they would come through, cut through the property and use it as a shortcut to get to the other road on the other side. Well, I built this gate to stop them from doing that. And so far it's worked well. Now before we put the electronic opener, we were just chaining it up, and we went through approximately 4 chains before we finally got the people to start coming through. And I actually got upset with cutting the chains, because every time you lose a chain and lock, you have to rekey not only this end but the other end. And with 7 property owners through this gate, it becomes rather troublesome. So for some reason, this isn't quite closing, but these are supposed to come together. I used to have a lock and pin that would come through across these two pieces and securely fasten them shut. But what we have here is we have a piece of square tube that can be removed, an additional stopper, because there is this small gate here. Now this gate right here is, I believe, 16 feet, and we have an additional 4 feet in case we need to get a heavy piece of equipment through. We didn't want to limit ourselves between the poles. This post over here is 4-inch by 4-inch by also 1/4-inch thick wall. And that doesn't go quite as deep, and this small gate has some slightly smaller hinges. But overall, nobody has tried coming through this gate. Nobody has tried ramming it, because they have a pretty serious deterrent to stop them from coming through. And like I said, I welded this up and installed it, augured the hole. And then another thing, because you got to remember, the chain is only as strong as the weakest link. People were wondering, okay, what happens if you go around the gate? Well, we also have a slight water drainage through here that it runs through. And I don't know if you can see, it actually dives down into a ditch and then has a berm. So if somebody were to try and drive over this, unless they have a really tall truck, they would just high center it. Same thing, even the side-by-sides can't come over it. So there's a nice water drainage trench followed by a berm. So there's no real way to get through here and go around the gate. Same thing over here. We dug out a drainage trench and put the dirt up on top, so as to create a security berm that nobody can really drive around. And then we have the cattle fencing with the T-posts, extra T-posts to help deter anybody from coming through. And overall did what we could to make this as secure of a system as possible. And so far it's worked. We haven't really had any issues. Now I mentioned locking it with a lock and a chain and keys and whatnot. We did that because we didn't want to go and install these openers that are approximately $2,000 when all said and done, and have somebody come and destroy that brand new opener. So we ran for quite a few months with just lock and chain before we actually installed the openers, to try and get anybody that wanted to try and come through the road weaned off and no longer allowed to access the place. And I actually did the lettering on here. I painted this section of the gate, I primered it and then painted it red, and then I cut out all these letters on a laser cutter. This was back when I was in high school, we had a laser cutter. Stuck them on, painted everything black, peeled off the stenciling, and then clear coated the entire gate. So this lettering has stood up pretty good. It says, warning, not a public use road, no trespassing. And we have the security cameras in use, so on and so forth. Now, for the opener, we do have a solar panel over there, and that keeps everything charged, so this is battery operated. And I'm gonna take you around to the other side and show you a little bit more in depth. So here we are on the other side. We have this locking mechanism, and it has a bolt going through because these usually just come with a pin. But somebody had actually cut that pin with a pair of bolt cutters. So this is a grade 8 hardened bolt. It's welded in at the top and welded in at the bottom so nobody can try and mess that up. Coming out of this, we have some half inch EMT. Now, even though this is not outdoor rated, we only have set screw couplings. All it's doing is protecting a wire. This was both for routing because I didn't want to route through the inside of the gate, and also to protect from physical damage. Couldn't really get away with running EMT down here because we need the pivot, so we just have a little bit of a security potential fault right there with the wire, but no big deal. And then I bent a piece of conduit going into the control box and just tack welded it onto the post because I couldn't get a strap in because this post is full of concrete, and tack welded it to the frame. And this is all low voltage, so again, it's just to protect from physical damage and to provide a routing method. So that's about it. That's the gate opener. I don't know exactly what model this is. Oh, there's the nameplate. Here is the nameplate on that gate opener. So if you want to pause and look that up. But this is the project I built. I believe I have a date in the concrete. So date in the concrete is July 30th, 2017. So that was a hot summer, fun mixing concrete. But it's been working. This is now May of 2019, so based on results, everything's working good. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a thumbs up. Otherwise, check out the other videos on the channel and subscribe. You've been watching High Tech Lab today. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.